Hi guys, you are welcome to Learning with Sped Class. I am Tutor Chima. Today we are going to be looking at why past question for the year 2018, and we are going to be treating biology. It's a fresh start for this year. In our previous videos, we've solved past questions on why jump, even on we've solved past questions on WAEC biology, rather both JAM biology and WAEC biology. That's what I'm trying to say. So in the previous videos, we've solved past questions on 2020, 2019. So now we'll be looking at 2018 biology. So it's going to be a fresh start. So we'll be looking at question number 1 to 5 for this particular year. So before we move to that, do not forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel, like our videos. When you look below there, you see a notification bell. I advise you to click it on so that you'll be the first to be notified whenever we have such an educational rich content on our channel. Do not forget to share this video, because there are many people who are who will be needing this video. You never can tell. So try as much as possible to like, comment, and also share. Your comment can just be a question, maybe on this section, or maybe your previous sections we've had. Maybe if there's any area you find challenging, maybe you need me to throw more light, try as much as possible to drop one or two questions. Okay, enough of that for today. Enough of that. Let us go straight to the business of today, which is solving past questions on WAEC for the year 2018, and the subject is biology. So like I said, we'll be starting from question number 1 to 5. One says, the scientists who introduced binomial nomenclature in the classification of organisms was, is it Charles Darwin, is it Carolus Linus, is it John Ray, is it Louis Pasteur? So they're asking us, the scientists that introduced this binomial nomenclature. Binomial nomenclature simply means the way in which living organisms are named according to what their scientific names, like rice, Oryza sativa, beans, Ignis vandiata, and so on and so on, and maize, Z maize, and so on. Sorry, beans is cowpea. I think that's I can't really remember the botanical name for cowpea now. Just Oryza sativa for rice, Z maize for beans, Carica papaya for purple. So that's what we mean by binomial nomenclature. And they're asking us, the scientists that introduced that. I believe Charles Darwin played a role in evolution. John Ray, I don't really know much about this person. Louis Pasteur was a scientist that wrote about how to pasteurize milk. How to what? Pasteurize milk, that is prepare milk in a very what? Clean and sanitary condition. Let us see. Carolus Linnaeus established the practice of binomial nomenclature, that is, the domination of each kind of plant by two words, the genus name and the species name, e.g., Zimens. Now, I've given you Zimens before, which is the botanical name for maize. So, the scientist that brought about binomial nomenclature is Carolus Linnaeus. So these two names, the first one is from the genus, the second one is from the species. When you're writing botanical names for living organisms, make sure that the genus is spelled with a capital letter and the species with a small letter. You have to separate them with a space. If you are typing it, you can write it in italics. But if you are writing it, if you are typing it, you can type it in italics. But if you are writing it in a book, you must underline the genus separately and underline the species separately. So the answer is what? Carolus Linnaeus. Carolus Linnaeus. Question 2. Which of the following statement is true about arthropods? Which of the following statement is true about arthropods? Now, I believe you know arthropods. Segmented living organisms that are invertebrates. Example is all these cockroach, perhaps insects like butterfly, arachnids like spider, scorpions, millipedes, and centipedes that belong to the myriapods. So we all classify them as what? Arthropods. Mm-hmm. So they're asking us which of the following statement about this organism is true. Is it that the prothorax bears only legs? Is it that the mesothorax bears only legs? Is it that the mesothorax bears only wings? Or is it that the prothorax bears only wings? Let us see. Now, the insect thorax, I'm using insect as an example of arthropods. Mm-hmm. The insect thorax consists of three segments called the prothorax, the mesothorax, and the metathorax, which may be fused but are usually recognizable. Each segment bears a pair of legs, thus both the prothorax, the mesothorax, and the metathorax bear a pair of legs. And in the mature insect, the mesothorax, the one at the center, and the metathorax, the terminating part of the thorax, typically carry a pair of wings. Therefore, the prothorax bears only legs. Sorry that I didn't show you, I didn't use an insect, maybe like, I think I wanted to use grasshopper to show you this thing, and you see how the working legs have been attached to the thorax, but I skipped my mind. I didn't remember to do that. Okay, so just like I said, the prothorax and the mesothorax and the metathorax all bear working legs. The first set of legs is, you know, the insect has six legs. I'm using insect as an example, and it has six working legs. The first two pairs is in the prothorax, the second two pairs, mesothorax, the last two pairs, the metathorax. Mm-hmm. But the wings is attached between the mesothorax and the metathorax. So the prothorax bears only legs. Mm-hmm. The prothorax bears only legs. So this one is the correct answer. Prothorax bears only legs. Mm-hmm. All right. Question 3. What level of organization is Spirogyra? I believe you know Spirogyra. Well, it's what kind of green substance that you can see, green organism you can see floating on the surface of water. You can see it in all this clean gutter water. Mm-hmm. Or in streams or so. That is Spirogyra. Most especially is mostly Spirogyra. Now you can easily see it because at least Spirogyra live in colony. Mm-hmm. They are the filamentous type. They have a kind of filamentous thread like filament, but they live in colony. So they're asking us what level of organization is Spirogyra. Is it the organ level? Is it the organ system? Is it the organ level? Is it cell level? Is it the tissue level? Okay, let us see. Spirogyra is a multicellular organism that is also plant-like protists. It is filamentous type of green algae found in freshwater bodies. So Spirogyra is a multicellular organism, which is an example of a plant-like protist. Mm? So it is a filamentous type of green algae found in freshwater bodies. So I said that since cells combine to form tissues, you know, cells combine to form tissues, tissues combine to form organs, organs combine to form organ system. So since cells combine to form tissues, and Spirogyra is multicellular, like that's many cells, therefore it belongs to the tissue level of organization. Now if Spirogyra is like a single cell, like a simple multicellular cell like Euglena, you can say it belongs to the cellular level of organization. But since they've told us that Spirogyra is a multicellular organism, multicellular meaning many cells, and we know that cell plus cell give tissue, so that means Spirogyra belongs to the tissue level of organization. So the correct answer is for tissue level of organization. Mm-hmm. 4. The streaming movement of the cytoplasm within paramecium is known as. Is it transpiration? Is it digestion? Is it cyclosis? Is it osmosis? This streaming movement doesn't apply to only paramecium. It applies to all living cells. Mm-hmm. Let us see what it is called. Digestion. Now, before we look at that, let's see the definition of each of. We are going to look at the definition of each of these: transpiration, digestion, cyclosis, and osmosis. Transpiration. Transpiration is a process by which plants conducts water from roots to the leaves, that is stem. It doesn't mention anything as regards cell movement. Digestion is the breakdown of food substances into simple assimilable form by enzymes in the digestive tract. It doesn't say anything as regards the cell. Cyclosis or cytoplasmic streaming, I believe we've seen an answer, is the constant movement of materials or cellular contents of the cytoplasm. I believe we've seen an answer. And there I say osmosis is the movement of water from the region of a low solute concentration to the region of a high solute concentration through a semi or selective polymer membrane. So we've seen an answer is cyclosis, which is cytoplasmic streaming, the constant movement of materials or cellular contents of the cell. So the correct answer is cyclosis. Cyclosis. Five. Which of the following organelles is found only in plant cells? Which of the following organelles is found only in plant cells? Is it mitochondria? Is it ribosomes? Is it lysosomes? Is it plastids? Let us see. Now let me explain the function of each of them. Then you can now tell me the one that is found only in plant cells. Mitochondria, responsible for cellular respiration. Of course, it will be found both in animal and plant cells because plant must always respire, use oxygen to break down glucose to liberate what energy which they can use to stay alive. So mitochondria is found in all eukaryotic cells, all advanced cells. Ribosome, responsible for protein synthesis. Ribosome responsible for manufacturing proteins. Plants need to manufacture proteins too, because proteins, they store proteins, are you following? By the time they use nitrogen to build up tissues, they now use it to form proteins that animal is being consumed. So ribosome is found in both in plant cell and animal cell. Lysosome, responsible for the production of digestive enzymes. Yes, both plant and animal needs digestive enzymes to break down certain tissues or certain cells in their words, in their bodies. Plastids, also known as chloroplasts, responsible for photosynthesis. Of course, we know that animals cannot carry out photosynthesis. They cannot manufacture their own food. Why can't animals manufacture their own food? Simply because they do not have a chloroplast or what? Plastids. So since animals like chloroplast or plastids, it is completely absent in their body cell. So the organelle that will be found only in plant cell is what? Chloroplast or what? Plastids. So your correct answer is what? Plastids. So only plastids can be found in plant cell. Only plastids can be found in plant cells. So I can say that what that can be found in plant cells here is only what? Plastids. Alright guys, we've come to the end of today's section of learning. In prep class, we looked at past questions on Biology Wire 2018. If you look here, you see a link. I want you to copy and paste this link on your browser. When you do so, you'll be getting updates and infos on the latest videos we have available on YouTube. So, we are going to wrap up the section today. Till we meet again, I remain Mr. Chima. Bye and we stay safe.